Feature Friday.
The freshest. What up, people? Welcome to Feature Friday. Today is Friday, and we're checking out some more hip-hop, Filipino rap.
You want me to tell you something mad?
Yeah, go ahead.
While you guys are watching this, yeah?
We are not here.
Yeah, we're definitely not here. We have to pre-record this because we're at 1MX rehearsal runs. Not only because we're there to kind of cover the event, but also we have rehearsal of our own. So that's pretty fucking
mad. Yeah, please keep your fingers crossed.
Yeah, send us prayers and good thoughts, yeah? I think
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Yeah, it's fine, mate.
It'll be fine.
I don't know.
It'll be fine.
You know what's cool is like, and the reason why it feels a bit different than to other shows that we've done and everything like that, it's just like the people that we've reviewed the music of are also there. And some of our favorite singers that we've discovered through the channel, like Casey Tandingan, Easy Mill, like Darren Svanto, Bamboo, for fuck's sake.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're going to be there and we're going to be rehearsing, you know, like after them. And then on the day, obviously we're going to hang out with them and stuff.
Yeah.
But, you know, we obviously have met them before and we have to make content with them and stuff like that. But it's still a mad experience and a huge, you know, it's a huge privilege.
It's a huge privilege.
Thank you so much. Shout out to ABS, TFC.
OneMX.
Shout out to everyone sort of that's made this happen for us. Shout out to our own teams. So it's quite mad. We'll probably go live when you guys are watching this.
We're
probably most likely live, maybe, before this gets published or maybe after. So do watch out. Lots of pictures, lots of content coming. You'll probably get all the content like on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, like next week because we need a breather. But
we actually need to edit all the stuff to send that you put it out there for y'all.
Yeah, all our team of editors right now is like,
oh my God.
But they do the best. We have some of the best girls, like genuinely, I think so.
Yes. Shout out Megan, shout out Nis, you guys rock.
Yeah. And we'll probably be working with some brand new editors as well because, like, we obviously want to evolve the channel, you know.
Definitely.
We are currently, you know, working hard at the sort of the Indian Bollywood and Indian cinema channel. And that seems to be going okay, you know, for 2 weeks. So we're working at that. And then hopefully within a few weeks, months, I'm going to be realistic here. Within a few months, we will launch the sort of the Asia channel, in which we will, you know, check out Filipino movies, K-dramas, Thailandese BLs and all this stuff. But anyways, we're here for hip hop. And the
Filipino
fucking
rap,
yeah? So this is my world.
So we have a really cool list of things. Like we have a...
Francis Magalona.
Yeah, we have
rest
some
in peace
legends.
Shout out, man.
Big rest in peace. And then you have also like the new scene, the new rise of the underground hip-hop that has taken the whole industry by a storm. Absolutely freaking viral for so many reasons. So we have a couple of those too.
Yeah, I think we've never reacted or reviewed like the underground scene, like battle raps. So we will for the first time. It's hard when you do this podcast, right? Because this is like my world. This is like my side of the river, yeah? And it's not really ballet side of the river. It's the same when we do like dance and stuff like that. That's like Valeska side of the river. Yeah, or like, you know, last week we did like K-pop dance, right? It's like, that's not really my side of the river. That's like Valeska's area of expertise. She's like a mermaid there. For me, I'm like a fucking, I don't know, I'm like a scorpion in water. That's a saying, I'm sure, somewhere.
What is the horse to water?
I don't know.
The idiom that you were like, oh, you can take a horse to water, but you can't teach.
You can teach. You can teach the horse how to fetch the water, but you can never teach the water how to be the fish. I don't fucking know. These idioms, these sayings make no sense, you know. But anyways, how are you, my capabayans, you know? Okay, I've chosen a different one. It's called Ito Ang Gusto Ko.
It has a whole music video to this.
Yeah.
It's a lot of dancing.
So let's give it a watch. Bit oldies. Never heard it either.
Ito Ang Gusto Ko. Yeah.
I'll find the lyrics as well.
I
Damn, their fashion was mad.
Yeah, right? Green screen was a thing.
It's the core. It reminds me so much of back home, man.
There's nothing more 90s than this music video right here. From the fashion to the music video editing. Yeah, you hear the alternative rock
right.
with hip-hop influences that I was talking about earlier? So cool.
Dang. It literally could be an alternative rock song, just... Oh, what the fuck?
Itong gusto ko. Itong gusto ko. But how freaking dope is this video, though?
Gusto ko. Ikaw, ko. The most interesting thing about him is that we'll check out the lyrics in a second, but this message, you mother.
This message was brought to you by who?
Oh, by Royal True Orange. You know what's interesting about him, and perhaps this is probably accurate to the sort of time. As the early 2000s, a lot of, you know, everyone sort of knows the genre that was kicking ass, not only in the Philippines, but kind of worldwide, was alternative rock music.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, pop was still doing what pop did, and actually pop
and
groups were doing fucking bits.
And hip-hop was at its thing, too, but it had its audience.
That's like, right, hip-hop was a niche. Yeah. It's not like it's nowadays where it's like a...
It's like commercial.
Full-on man. Thing, yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, if you want to have a hit, you could make it rap. As a matter of fact, like, Sam Smith, it's like in a song that didn't need a rap. It's like, nowadays, you're going to have one.
Yeah.
I really did not like that fucking... rap, Jesus Christ. No shade to that girl. What's her name?
I don't know.
Kim something.
Kim?
Yeah, fair play, man. She made a huge hit. One of the biggest hits ever, right? Like at the moment.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fair play to her, but fuck me, that verse was utter.
Well, we did garbage. See the Efra's talking about the BBC radio live performance that
Sam Smith is great,
just did.
Man.
And he brought out a whole choir, a gospel choir, with the arrangement. The song is good. Musically speaking, and his performance was flawless.
Feature was questionable.
I don't have anything against the feature. I have something against the lyricism, and maybe
the verse,
song
like
itself,
she's all right. The girl's like, all right. Please. I'm not saying I have to do anything against the woman. The girl's fine, but the verse that the girl came up with, fuck me.
I think both lyricisms, like the lyricism in both parts, was a little bit like questionable at times. You know.
Anyways, but yeah, so pop, you know, was always doing his thing in early 2000s. Hip hop wasn't as big as it is now. Where now every fucking song
but
has to have
rock.
Rap. rock was kicking ass.
Yeah.
Now, what you would imagine, if you want to become commercial with anything at that specific time, yeah, why don't you mix both, right? Yeah. So it takes kind of like a visionary guy to also then, well, not only do you know it's going to be popular because of this, it's going to break boundaries because it's such a weird mix of genres, alternative rock with fucking 90s US West Coast hip hop. What in the fuck?
Cool.
And then you can put a nice message behind it. Mm-hmm. You can, you know, perhaps make commentary on societal issues at that time. I do wonder what the song is about. So let me do a little bit of a little translation.
To be completely honest, the chanting aspect of the chorus is such a hack. Again, that was so popular back in the 90s. It got lost quickly, though, which I think it's a shame when you think about it, because it really brought out the whole sing-along type of idea for a live performance events and stuff.
It means... Oh,
I
see.
It is what it is.
No. So it means like, this is what I want. Ito ang gusto ko means this is what I want. Live properly and fully. Give to others. Love yours. I want to taste the relish of life. Hold on open to King's hands. See, no one knows. See which. See light in the dark. I don't want the dark circles. The freedom you hope to give me. Live of true color the life. Tears will be offered to the lives offered. Our life cannot be challenging. Defend our rights. Justice, this is what I want. Freedom, this is what I want. Peace, this is what I want. Human rights, this is what I want. Nature, this is what I want. Youth, this I want. Friends, this is what I want. In my life, this is what I want. And then it goes on to the second verse.
Right.
I want to embrace the sweetness of time. Trust that I had to go beyond yesterday. I don't want to lose hope. I want happy memories. Together, manifold, simultaneously, top or bottom. What is the phone number of the Westbrook Historical Society in Westbrook, Maine? How do you get a girl to, oh, Jesus, okay. I can't say that word. Act properly and abstain from scar. There is only one person. Interpret the present. Honor, this is what I want. Health, this is what I want. Goodness, this is what I want. And you can kind of get a honor, health, goodness in my life. This is what I want. Again, so I think
social commentary.
Social commentary. Also, he's fucking hood. Yes. You know what I mean? He's gonna speak however the hell he wants to speak. And that's kind of like a big FU back in the day, because like Mother and I were discussing this. It's like, you know, we grew up in television, you know, and the way I speak here, which is the same way I speak when the cameras are off, that would not flow if we were this, if the show wasn't ours.
Yeah, yeah. Like, if we were produced by a big TV company like we used to be back home, like
I can't even use like specific words. It's not even about the swearing, like fuck or whatever, because I know some people are like, oh my god, or other people it's like, who cares? But it's like in TV, it's like I'm abiding to their rules, but here I make the rules, so it's fine. But in there, it's like I have to bow down and abide to their rules. But this is my bloody show, you know what I mean? But it's not if you're in TV, or there's ways the industry works.
Well, there's certain things that you can and cannot say when you're under an umbrella.
You're like, suck on my big Irish balls.
You're not even Irish.
Everyone knows there's a reference to Conor McGregor.
A lot of people don't.
They love and pride of Ireland, yeah.
Nobody knows.
Because my best friend is Irish, so it's fucking hilarious. We always take them.
Listen, like I said, there are things that if we were under a bigger umbrella, we wouldn't be able to say. And I actually quite like the fact that we have such freedom. Oh, well, a little more freedom than we used to have when we were,
we don't feel free.
Well, I think there's still like regulations or rules, which I think are necessary for this, for online world.
Yeah, yeah.
But
Susan Wojcicki, I'm talking directly to you. I'm only joking. Maybe we should keep her as a friend, because then if we ever do hit the 1 million, then maybe she'll be like, I saw your video.
Efra, you know how many channels?
Susan Wojcicki.
You know how many channels?
That's not my name, Efra. So there we retract our plaque.
Could you imagine in her? Because you know they send a letter, a generalized letter of congratulations with each plaque.
Yeah, I can't wait.
could you imagine that the 1 million plaque letter comes in like directly? Dear Efra, my name is not
Susan Wojcicki. Mike Wazowski.
No, it's not.
Anyways, very nice.
Yes, very nice.
Let's proceed, shall we? Yeah, let's proceed. By the way, look at this. I actually never knew how he passed away.
Oh, okay.
How he died, basically. And then it turns out everyone in Google Is Francis Magalona still alive? He's not fucking... What is he like? Maybe it's like in... You know how Tupac, there's that whole thing on the internet. Acute... Oh my God, leukemia.
Oh my God.
Holy fuck.
That is horrendous.
Wow. Magalona was later awarded a posthumous Presidential Medal of Merit. Wow. Ooh. So after he passed away, oh fuck. God damn it. Why not while he was alive?
Yeah, why not? I always question that, you know, when people are like...
Well, sometimes it takes dramatic events to sort of, you know,
to
things.
Appreciate.
Because maybe
greatness.
People always knew how sort of great he was.
He was always very highly regarded by the things that you guys always say.
That's a nice picture.
But it's, dude, that's heartbreaking.
Well, nice man. Anyways.
Heartbreaking.
Let's have a look at this. Oh my God, Wish. This is Glock 9, of course, but with a new name that we've never checked out. JRLDM. Maybe Geraldimum. Geraldimum. I love Glock 9 as well, man.
These guys are so cool. This video is so popular, and it released like last month or something like that.
Ooh. Emotional piece, it seems.
Hey. Oh. I love Tagalog, dude.
Mad mannerisms, right? Like,
it's proper relaxed the way you're singing it. I love that. The fact that he sounds like that live, it's mad to me.
God, I like him.
Yeah. Oh, this is hot.
Oh, Glock is gonna snap.
Right? Can I request a Philippe feature?
Pangarapko para sa itsat. Anko kayo, mahal ko kayo, mahal kita. hanggang sa uli, hanggang dito na lang. Halo, halo. Paubaya. Bro, I'm fucking snapping. Araw gabi, hangga suli, halo, halo, paubaya. That's fucking green. That sounds amazing.
That's not. That's
I'm sure
not
it makes sense
cringy,
as well.
Bro.
Yeah, you know what? Cringe. I have to be completely honest. Cringe. It's not cringe.
It is.
I don't like that word. I refuse to accept that because I don't like that word. You know what? I do have to apologize because if one clown on the internet was doing that in Spanish and it was just writing random shit, you know, compromiso muy bonito, I'd be like, what the fuck, dude? Jesus.
But it'd
be hilarious.
Funny,
yeah, it'd be hilarious. So maybe
you would find it
hopefully,
funny.
I don't mean any disrespect, but also my vocabulary is very, very limited in Tagalog. But maybe at some point, though, because
I feel like you just spew out nonsense.
Yes. Sisu! I'm not going to try to defend myself. Fuck it. Bows deep now. I'm staying in.
I was going to say.
Felipe. Yeah, yes. Good call up. Good. Well said.
Oh, sir.
Oh, Dito Kalang. I knew that one. Ikaw. Oh, what does Lagi Nalang mean? Oh.
That's so sick. Such a simple approach, though. It's vibe. So effective. Somebody broke their hearts.
I love this beat. Fuck.
I like this guy. I like him a lot. How do you say his name?
Jeromondo.
I'm a fan. Dude. Yeah. 107.5. Ah, that was hot.
Amen.
Sick.
Bro.
And all those.
That's so cool.
And all those walking by, they just, you know, got to experience that whole thing.
Shout out the Wish Bus.
Shout out.
Big friends to the channel.
Listen, it's so dope because you're hearing here, like, the singing influences by, I don't know how to say his name.
Wow, this is so famous. This has 1 million views.
Yeah, and it was, like, released, like, in early August. It's not that.
JRLDM.
He freaking rocks. I love his relaxed way of singing because that man could sing 4 hours. Like, I'm not even joking. The mannerisms of the way he has approached singing has allowed him to be literally unbreakable. Whoa. That's so freaking cool.
Look at this. Look at this. An enemy.
Oh, sick.
JRLDM. Filipino rapper who went from Batans. No, stupid ad. God. Well, I guess get your money, dog.
Batans factories
to making stock songs about love, vice, and inner darkness. Gerald Malari tells NME.
Malari. what you say, like, it's a Harry Potter spell. Malari. It's Malari or something, no? You're saying it like...
How a frank and forthright song about self-harm transported him to recording the rap heroes with rap heroes like Glock 9 on his debut album Mood Swing. That's a vibe, that picture there.
Yes, we love freaking rice stories like that.
He also wears his underwear really up high, though.
Okay.
For a decade since he was a high school freshman, Gerald
Malari
would take Sundays off.
I was trying to put it into perspective.
Would take Sundays off to write and record songs, then toil in Batam's textile factories. Holy fuck. The rest of the week. Last year, the Mariveles,
born artist,
was still getting little attention for his music. And with troubles exacerbated, oh, that's a good word, exacerbation, that means to get worse by the pandemic, decided something had to give. It was time, he figured, to quit hip-hop and leave the Philippines for a better-paying job overseas.
Oh, really?
He's 26 years old. What? Pronounced Geraldam.
Geraldam.
Geraldam. That's how it's pronounced. Geraldam. This Geraldam? Geraldam.
Geraldam.
The 4-track EP, Look Mom, I'm Flying, but what Malari thought was a last-ditch effort turned into the beginning of what looked from the outside like overnight success.
That
but it
is
certainly
sick.
Fucking wasn't, was it?
No, there was years of grueling suffering.
I think today's listeners are smart enough to know that I'm not glorifying suicide. Oh, fuck, I said the word. But bringing awareness to what's going on underneath. Right, so it is quite heavy shit. Very nice, man. Fair play, son. I'm so look at his vibe though. Vibes. Come on, dog.
I'm telling you, and the fact that he sounds like that. Yeah. Insane.
Also, something very cool is
cool as hell.
With that type of sort of vocal, you know, texture, ability, and the sort of you know, ease of execution, this guy's gonna be around for a long time. As long as he doesn't do crazy shit.
Well, the fact that he can sound like that in an environment like Wish, it's absolutely mind blowing. Again, I think we have seen plenty of performances that have gone right on the channel, but we have also seen some that don't, and they are painful to watch because it's true though, they make you kind of like whoa, but it puts into perspective how incredibly difficult it is to pull it off in an environment like this, and it's nerve-wracking, and it takes incredible amount of discipline and self-awareness to bring such a great performance into this environment. So I really do like what was happening here, dude. That was sick. Oh yes, John Dra. That's on the list.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice. I was just checking who's sort of gone. Can we watch it?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, because this is my show. That's actually not my show. It's Baleska's show. It's just, feel like the power is now given to me.
Since we swapped. And he has the the power to do
woo,
this.
Woo, woo, woo.
Yeah, I feel like he's just, you know.
I'm pretty good at it, though.
I think you're awesome at it. It takes away the stress.
Okay, let's give this a look. I was just checking who's sort of been in the Wish bus.
Yes. John Roy has been kicking it lately.
Yeah, he's been very active, actually. Shout out, John. He's been on the podcast. If you haven't seen the podcast, you probably should, because he's so awesome.
Dope.
And he's a nice man. Like, and what a journey he's been to. Mm. And it's so good to see him sort of settle and just fucking grind now. Anyways.
Well-deserved success. Oh, Sukatan. Yeah. Oh, to me, it's just the little things like doubling up the voice.
Oh, that beat is fat. Juicy.
Woo! You see what I mean? It's the little details that just bring it to a new level.
John!
J-Raw, baby, that's so sick! Oh, this dude is so talented, I love that.
Plano.
Compano.
What's his name? Looney. Looney's fucking... Oh my God, Looney.
Looney.
From Looney from... He does rap battles.
He does rap battles?
Yeah. Is it the same person?
I don't know.
I don't know. Sometimes they look so different when they... Like, because they're wearing fucking glasses.
Things and then they...
Yeah, yeah. We're going to see him rap, battle rap. Fucking hell.
Is it the same person?
That's mad, yeah.
Same.
That's sick. Anyways.
Okay, just continue.
So he can rap. So I watch Flip Top sometimes.
Flip Top?
Huh?
Flip Top.
Battle rap from the Philippines. It's John. He's so creative when it comes to these type of hooks. He's so clean.
Oh, damn. Hey.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, this guy's like must be he's like a demon rapping.
Oh damn, this beat.
Alcatraz. Yeah, John's actually doubling up on so much.
So much. Oh, brilliant. What a breath.
And like our experience of this is so limited because obviously we like the lyricism, which is like fucking 80% of it.
But the tension building throughout that was absolutely insane.
And then escape what?
Means escape, like right? Getting out, yeah.
To escape.
Yeah.
Dude, John's voice is so sick.
Yeah. Listen, that was
I wish I could sing like that, dude. Like, John has the voice that I wish I had. Like, if you know what I mean, it's like the cool voice, like that's probably the voice you used to, like, it's the same as like Skosta Klee.
No, it's the
Umahasa voice, you know?
Do you know who I think it sounds like that? Like, I wish I could sound like that.
What?
Freaking Kel Palinglinan.
Oh, Kel. Yeah.
Pangilinam. To me, that is like the voice, you know? In R&B, when he sings R&B, he's like,
Mr. Cool Guy.
Yes.
Yeah, so... talk about Flip Top. So Flip Top Ballet is like this is what I'm a bit like. I mean, I hope you enjoy this. Maybe
this is the battle rap that we were talking about earlier.
And Mark Grist, he's actually British. I actually don't know what part of Britain he's from, and this is all in English.
I thought he sounded pretty posh, like very London-esque, but in the well-spoken area.
probably might be from London. Who knows? I don't know. But he's a very good lyricist.
Not cool. Now but he's a rapper.
Yeah, he battle raps, yeah. So for you, like battle rap, which when I played a second of it, because I was just looking when it began, Ballet was like, oh my God, it sounds like spoken word.
It does.
You have to understand that like, so battle rap and then hip hop, they're a bit, not different, but it's, you know, one of them doesn't necessarily need music and then the other one does have a beat. And like a beat is a big deal from it.
Yeah.
And then you also have battle rap with music, right? Where you have like a DJ, that's like that whole scene of like Imao that everyone knows.
Mm-hmm.
That shit's real. It does happen. You probably don't. Yeah, you actually even get bars at that level. Like, you know, because obviously it's a movie, it's prescripted and everything.
Yeah.
But you do get bars at that sort of level, that sort of advanced stuff. But in this type of battles, imagine it like you're having an insult battle, basically.
Okay.
Like a paw, you know, like when you you didn't go to school here. Someone's like abusing you verbally, but you're trying to give it back to them. It's like an argument.
Okay.
It's like a debate, essentially.
Okay.
But your job is not to be
the wittiest, who comes up with the smartest thing.
Wit's certainly part of it.
Okay.
But I think you're trying to convince the audience and portray to the audience that there is no way in hell that this guy's in the same level as you.
All right.
That he's illiterate. That's essentially what you're trying to, you know, and that's when it comes, kind of, that's where you see similarities of spoken word. I have seen a few episodes of Flip Top. It's very, very fucking popular. And I actually never knew that it was from the Philippines. I just presumed it was somewhere in Asia or something. Because this is back in the day when I was sort of watching it, like, you know, maybe 3 years ago, prior to like the channel. They're so mm-hmm. fucking famous, this channel. And it has like 6 million
subscribers.
Yeah, yeah. And I remember like some of the first videos I saw. Yeah, like they're old as fuck. They've been in like 13 years ago. Yeah, they've been doing it for a really long time. And some of them are like in English, same as this one. So let's give this a little watch. And obviously, if you're enjoying it, we keep watching a bit more. This is a big scene in the Philippines. So we have to do it justice when we sort of check out
underground rap.
Yeah, which we never have on the channel because it's not for everyone.
Yeah, that's
right. It's a reason why it's underground. It's not very commercial.
Yes.
So do keep in mind.
Prepping for this match was torture. Arik, I can't thank you more. You took me on a massive tour. This land is gorgeous. He even shared his battle formula. The way you prep is mad important. Pegasus, Air Force One, and happy sauna. I was nervous, but they were very nice.
There will be things that go over your head. Kind of look at it like a stand-up. Kind of look at it like a...
Who's illiterate now?
No, well, for you. But if there's anything you don't understand, sort of just ask me.
Okay.
And I'll try and do my best. But it also...
He's coming up with this stuff in the moment, in the spotlight. Well, he didn't prepare this?
No, it's like a match. So you know who you're going to go up against.
Okay.
The problem is...
It's like MMA.
So you prepare, it's quite combative, yeah.
So you prepare for your opponent.
Exactly, but...
You don't know what's going to happen in the time.
In the moment, yeah. So the most interesting sections are like towards the end or like the middle, because that's like when...
Shit gets real.
It's time to respond. You don't know what the fuck is going to prepare for you. Okay. You might know your weaknesses. You might know... He might talk about my weight. He might talk about my fucking... I look like, you know, I sell donuts or something.
Yeah.
Like I'm a, you know, like fucking belong in the Simpsons or something. You know what I mean? He might look at my... He might talk about my appearance, or he might talk about my fucking family. Or something like that, you know what I mean? Or if it's a scandal and people know about it and they're all, you turned down that battle, people, right. You're a pussy, you know what I mean?
Okay.
This is that world. Like, this isn't like, this isn't showbiz, bro.
All right.
So, okay.
They said he goes there every night.
Strippy, uh-huh. Yeah?
And now this punk is what he gets me. Just some bum who thinks he's destined to be worshipped for his earnings, mate. Your money don't impress me. I'll punch you in a frenzy till I'm rupturing your belly, pull your guts out, hang intestines from the rafters and the belfry.
That's pretty clever.
Like sherry, crush your nuts into confetti. Then I'll ring your girl and yell, we've saved a bunch upon our wedding. It's gonna get
That's very clever.
Messy, but a knife. The machete, this puppy's blood will spurt, but first, I'd love to get a selfie. Would that be all right?
Will that be all right?
It's very nice, son. Thank you. See, for a while now, I've been trying to take a bunch of shots to illustrate the lowest ebbs of human nature.
So oh my God, roasted!
How did you not see that coming,
yeah,
dog?
It was like a catch. That was such a nerd catch.
So
is that ouch?
So many things that make me think I'm lucky. Life's okay, yeah?
Well, prick.
Like a dog that's lost its tail, or a guy who's missed a train, or a bunch of guys I've met who've been sleeping rough for days. Without one picture of your face, that is proper fucking failure. I mean,
oh my God.
The other stuff is really bad, but that could be my screensaver. I mean, no one would fall in love with this. You look like a deflated puffer fish. One eye closed, shite closed, hair on your chin that's like a goat's, nostrils so far apart they each have their own time zones.
God damn. Yeah, so again, there's no punches being pulled in. Is the other bit, actually, interestingly enough,
Bro, could you imagine during security is being thrown at you?
yeah. Like,
no, I could never.
Yeah, like it's brutal. This is why I So this is how you begin usually in rap in Venezuela as well.
Mm-hmm.
You will most likely, you're probably the shy kid that wrote in school.
Mm-hmm.
Because rap wasn't that sort of popular. Reggaeton was, but rap wasn't. And then you had underground sort of sects. You know, you had these fucking cult-like places.
Correct.
They would gather at nighttime in this, you know.
Sometimes they would gather in, like, parks. Or, yeah. Like, it would be the sketchiest things.
Or places where you, you know, legally, really shouldn't have been in there. but no one's going to snitch.
No.
And also, you know, it's like a third world country, so no one gives a fuck.
Sometimes even the police just stopped out white.
Yeah, they stop outside just in case no one's like, you know, acting mad. But you build your confidence, your wit, your ability to think on the spot, and you're also your literacy. This is something that sometimes gets overlooked. Mm-hmm. You know, pronunciation. You're speaking to a crowd. Modulation. Mm-hmm. You want to. You know, there are actual pinnacle things and elements and components.
That's why I related it so quickly to spoken word, because a lot of its foundations are set in stone when it comes to spoken word.
Yeah, certainly.
Again, when you study acting, straight acting for playwrights, especially in theater, you got to study speech itself and voice itself. So a lot of those principles are so prevalent in this particular case, in this particular example, that it took me a while to understand how this being so confrontational, like it's a way of expressing. Well, it's rap, but its foundations are so solid in the way of spoken word itself, that even the rhyming and the tempo management of exertion of words is actually quite similar to what you would learn in a Shakespearean like class. Or it's funny though, because a lot of it comes from there.
That's what I mean. If it's in English, obviously English literature, you're seeing, you know, components and sort of very you know what you call it, compulsory elements to be as successful at anything.
Like the rhythm in which is spoken,
yeah.
It follows really closely to how you learn to recite Shakespearean prose.
His was interesting as well. It's like, he's also, because again, you have to cater to the audience you're speaking. You know, obviously in the Philippines, everyone speaks English, so this is, you know, quite a blessing for Mark. But if you were to look at sort of the American sort of type of bars in underground scenes, they would be a little bit more
rhythmical.
Not rhythmical. A lot of things would go more things would go over your head.
Right.
Because there's so much more introduction of slang, so more introduction of a rupture of pronunciations, things that we've never fucking heard in our lives because we didn't grow up in fucking Chicago. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So this is actually not a bad sort of thing to look at for you.
Those are wide. I bet when you picked it, you weren't all that subtle. Did you dig the finger in right up to the knuckle? Did you lift it and spin it? Did you get your whole fist in? Did you hammer in both like some pneumatic pistons? Whenever you sniff, does the furniture drift in? I heard it sucked up his grandma when she lent him to kiss him.
When
the wind starts to pick in, does it fill up with dogs and cats and pigeons? I heard at weekends, if he's got a spare hour to fit in, he likes to install the odd art exhibition. It's a wide nose. Plus, that cap and shaved head are quite scary, you know? But I'd shave my hair too if my hair didn't grow. I mean, come on. Don't be surprised that he's there because he needs it. We all know the truth. Your hairline's receding. If he took that thing off, you could see it retreating. I guess it's not just Sony Records that wants to up and leave him.
He was with Sony.
Damn, Papi, that was rude.
You don't need no cosmetics. You're like a one-man Filipino Venice, just with the nostrils of an evil ferret. And the hairline of Magneto's helmet.
Oh my God, Magneto! Jesus Christ!
Magneto helmet. Bro, wait.
Time.
Oh, they got time. Okay, they got time. They're timed like they are in like a dance battle.
Well, right. Yeah. Well, okay. What the fuck? If not, it'd just be you grilling the other guy.
I didn't know. Okay.
Hey, yo, your mum.
Now roast the potatoes.
Well, it's also, remember, there's a sporting element of this. He is playing at home. He is competing at home.
Ay, pobre Blanquito, he's about to get roasted.
You're a battle rapping teacher. according to the pamphlets. I'm always looking forward to your matches because they're as boring as your classes.
Oh, nice. Okay.
He likes to call himself a metaphorical assassin. Bro, you're such an adorable.
We can't use that word in YouTube.
After using his four-wheeler bag as a portable casket.
Oh.
You're a full-time teacher, right?
Teacher.
Fly-by rapper. You can't kick it with me, Grist. I'm a Muay Thai master. The type to body bag you and give you a high five after, especially if you're asking for it. Like the Wi-Fi password. Now, you really think that you can win here with your nice guy swagger? Nice try.
Oh, damn.
You should have worn that suit and tie designed with a tie-dye pattern and a t-shirt inside that says White Lives Matter. I hope you fucking die of cancer, you like.
This is a different world, I'm telling you. This is a different world. Yeah. This is what I mean. This is like, this is the roughest. Yeah, but that's the, you might not see a lot of this stuff. It's because they'll even block the podcast and it's just a mad one. But so we'll probably skip over this. I didn't think of that actually. How do people check this shit out on YouTube? Maybe they don't.
How is it up in YouTube? Well, question.
Well, I don't think they care. Like, you say they get demonetized or whatever, or blocked or age restricted. I don't care.
But it's not though.
We don't know.
No, like, if it was age restricted, it would say.
You think?
Okay. Yeah, it gives you a warning.
Well, mad one. Yeah, well, it's fucking
what?
Rap. Bale is like.
I just want to find out who wins. Okay, just go to the.
Using
end.
To eat till Donald Trump's pubes are removed.
Oh my
okay.
God, bro.
Okay.
Just figure, fuck it. One sniff from the west, just watch him go running. I won't be surprised if you hide in my luggage. I'm finished with this kid who sees my passport as a thing of dreams. He'd pack up all his things and leave, ignoring what's there in the scene. I mean, loony, mate. You're killing me. It's a symphony, such history. The love and warmth is in these streets. I mean it, mate. I don't want to leave. I fucking love the Philippines.
Well, different stories, different struggles, buddy.
This gig's been dope. I don't want to go, but it's time to bring this thing to close. If you're smart, you'll know how the multi goes.
Putain in a mold! Hi, okay.
Yo!
It does make me uncomfortable.
That pathetic piece of performance art didn't move me at all like the royal guard. I killed him in 90 seconds like a poisonous dart. I ain't got no problem stalking a mark.
So this is, again, pre-written, a lot of this stuff. But it's, what would you call it? It's a... is their uncanny ability to bring things out of their bag.
Oh, okay.
But they do have chance to prepare. It is a match.
Okay.
Fucking hell, even I'm rhyming all of a sudden.
It's like a prostitute in Lunetta. Just another walk in the park.
Oh. Thank you. Wow.
It's pretty awkward, eh? I don't know what to say, but I guess standing in front of you makes me want to talk this way.
Pretty nice.
You talk all day. That little leaf's whack. That's why I sit here in the Philippines trying to make his mark on the Philippine map with his Mr. Bean swag. I'm the president.
That was nice.
Punisher's bringing the guillotine back. You're about to fade away like that skinny jean fad. This mismatch is a mishap. I'm predicting this will be bad. Kind of like Duterte's middle finger against the British Queen's twat. Now it's pretty obvious that I'm about to body this faggot-ass battle rap hobbyist with action Bronson tits.
Whoa.
You're way past your prime, but still you're an optimist. Stop it, Brisk. You're older than a floppy disk.
Damn, this guy loony fucking goes crazy. I guess that's why they call him loony. Because he's a fucking lunatic. You see his eyes, like.
Yeah, but
I'm coming
Mark,
for your throat.
Mark was also so invested. He's coming up so close to his personal space, like, and he's like intently.
Well, this is
listening.
Normal. That's as to you that may seem a bit mad. But that,
not
that's
normal.
That's quite normal. I mean, a lot of the time, actually, they're like fucking really up close like that. Yeah, but even closer. Like you should see the derby matches of underground,
derby.
Yeah, underground rap battles in the UK. It's like some guy from fucking Liverpool and then some guy from Manchester United that supports Manchester United.
And that's a big beef.
Yeah, Manchester and Liverpool, that's beef. Or like, Arsenal
That's a steak. That's not beef. That's a steak.
Yeah, yeah. It's like
I don't know. I'm making shit up. But I don't know anything about this.
There's like real animosity behind it. However, it is a sport. That's the thing. There's no federation yet, and it's not, at least not to my knowledge. I stopped following this shit like 10 years ago. I was watching this stuff with this language and stuff when I was like 11, 10, so nice. You can imagine. On my way to school in the bus and shit, you know?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got beat by definition and a fucking retard. That makes you the perfect definition of a fucking retard. Now, I know that nobody in here gets it. And I respect it, but accepting this battle was a big mistake, and he regrets it like Brexit. Now check it, I'm a legend. They refer to me as Alamak. I'm about to crush this ginger and turn him into Salabat.
Oh, clever, clever.
But for my final bars, I have a different battle plan. I will use my Jollibee call center accent so everyone can understand. I'm here to leave a lasting impression on Mark like a cattle brand.
And this motherfucker really turned Filipino all of a sudden. He turned Filipino with a P. Filipino.
Standard fan because I'm teacher's enemy, number one. Tagalog or English, I'm flexible like a rubber band. You want to Mortal Kombat with me, Mr. Russell Brand? I'm like Toro with the four arms. I got the upper hand.
Damn, that's fucking fire. Oh, that was really good. I have to say, he's also arguably at a disadvantage, right? Looney.
Who is Looney?
Yeah, because, you know, you might speak a bit of English in the Philippines, but it's not your fucking first language.
Yeah, I see. Yeah.
Now, this is something that you cannot extinguish. It's gruesome when I depict this, and you cannot distinguish. Do you know what else rhymes with distinguish? Extinguish? Relinquish? Tsaka po kinang ina yung mga British na ubusan na ako ng English!
Ay, se quedó. Does that make him the winner? Is he winning now?
Boom!
Looney!
Yeah, you gotta win the crowd.
Right.
You know, you win. Like, if you know, at the end, I'm sure they'll shake hands and happy days and shit.
Is that usually how it goes?
I mean, it depends.
Oh. Ah, okay. What the? Bro, I am so confused by all of this.
Yeah, like.
Ah, so he wins.
Yeah, I think also as well, the more you watch this, you always get a feeling of who won.
Ah, right.
You know?
It's like dance battles, like hip-hop dance battles.
You always kind of have an understanding.
Yeah, you already know.
Also, I remember when I used to watch them, there was always the curse of going first.
Right, same as in dance battles. This is the closest. Okay.
Well, because if you finish, if you start, you don't end.
The thing is, the beginning, the closest thing for me to this is definitely the dance world, the dance scene. Like that's the closest thing I've ever come close to understanding what battling is in the spotlight, especially when it comes to dance freestyle. I always thought it was such a hard thing, like it was so exposing. I was never really good at it, but I went to a few battles myself here in London. They're pretty cool though, like the whole atmosphere is really dope. But years ago it used to be so aggressive. Now it's such an amicable place to be, you know, like it was never, again, it could get really physical and it could get really confrontational years and years ago
in dance,
like hip-hop dance battles, dude, they were hardcore.
Yeah, I don't want to disrespect or anything. It's just a bit mad. Like, to me, like, I don't know, like...
And I went to a few.
Would they not say shit? Would they talk shit to each other? Or is it just dance?
It's like dancing, but it's hard to explain, but, like, they would come at you, you know? Like, they would mimic your move or the stuff that you're stylistically known for, and they throw it at your face and make fun of it. It's exactly the same as is happening with words, but with dance.
Yeah, I don't know. I've never...
I'm sorry. I don't know how to make it.
I've always looked at the dance stuff, and I've never understood how you can get pissed.
Believe me, this crew.
I guess if you're really that, if you're that involved and stuff, but I think there must be beef beforehand.
Oh, definitely.
Those are the best battles when there's beef.
Yeah,
they're fucking hilarious because there's no pulling of any punches, bro. You're trying to knock their head off.
Same. Again, it's similar concept.
You're trying to knock their head off with what, a pirouette?
It's not pirouettes. There's not ballet.
My mad side is coming out because obviously
it's not ballet, dude. They're doing hip hop. and like locking and popping and freestyling and stuff. Mm. It's pretty sick. There's like a bunch of stuff happening now and like in the dance.
Yeah, I don't wanna ridicule it. It's just not for me, you know. I don't know how. Yeah.
Okay. I'm just telling you. That's the closest thing.
Yeah. Well, I've actually never been in it live. I've never experienced it live.
It is cool. Nowadays, it's actually pretty dope. Like, it's a thing to watch. It's a show. A lot of the times, like, it's so sick. It's a show.
So much beef has been happening, like, when I was sort of watching it, like, about 9 years ago.
The rap battles?
Yeah, of course. The real battles.
Sorry.
There was so much real beef going on that, like, you know, people were starting to get shot fucking, you know. So it's like, you don't want to be going there. It's a mad one. Like, I don't know how it is in London.
You were also a kid, though.
But I always looked at this stuff, and then you were like, and then you would look at, you know, like the rumors and stuff, and people were talking about it. That's why you pulled up to his house, because you ain't got no respect for his mama. You showed up, you know what I mean? You're like, oh my God, what the?
It was getting too serious.
Yeah, it was getting mad. Yeah, and then I kind of separated myself from that. Also, my mom sort of like didn't like it.
I wonder why.
Yeah, yeah. That's why it came out all weird. But yeah, man, very nice to have a look at that.
Interesting. Not gonna lie, that's pretty interesting stuff.
It's a different world. Like, it's a different world from, like, that's what I mean. Like, commercial. That's why there's so many layers, and that's why there's so many levels. Like, then you look at Looney. Imagine we didn't know that he had such a background in underground rap. You would just presume, he's just a gifted rapper.
He's so lyrical. He's so smart. Witty in English.
Imagine in fucking Tagalog.
Yes. Yeah,
and also the funny thing is, like, then you would listen to his songs and say you didn't know about his sort of underground pedigree. You would just think, what a great rapper. He sort of learned and stuff. Nah, bro. Like, this is under the fire.
Yeah,
this is like, it'd be ridiculed or be the hero. There's no in between in battle rap. It's like you lose or you win,
right?
You know, very rare. There's been a few draws, rare that I remember. Because it is entertainment at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Anyways,
dude, but that's wild.
Let's have a look at it. Let's know if you enjoyed that. Yeah. let us know. Maybe other underground rappers that I should know. I don't know if we'll check this out ever again on the channel. Remember, this isn't my channel. This is Maluchita's channel.
No, to be completely honest, I don't have anything against it. I think it's vastly entertaining. And it is so cool to use the vocabulary that gets exposed and, like, the things that they use and how fun they can be without really... I think the alliteration part is really fun. Again, I would love to do that if it weren't so explicit. We're totally going to get, like, you know, like, beep, 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 beep.
It wasn't us saying it. I don't give a fuck.
No, I know, but we are showing it.
Well, then, I don't know. It's your channel. Bleep it. I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, let's have a look at Flo G.
Okay.
Shall we?
I like Flo G.
This is that 44 bars challenge. That sort of Easy Meal became, you know, incredibly popular for. Yeah. Glock 9 also did it. A bunch of rappers did it.
Yeah, so this was so popular.
I've never seen Flo G's one.
Okay. Tribal Rap Challenge.
I love those studios. It's so sick. It's all one shot. Hit. Nice layers.
Bro, the breath control is mad.
Ugh.
Bro, that's dope.
Jesus, breathe.
That is so hard.
Maputahan. Oh, I know that word, viaje, as well.
Viaje means journey.
Yeah. Yo, I have to say as well, like,
that's pretty dope.
There's so many benefits to Tagalog. Like, if you actually think about it in a technical perspective for rap, I think I've mentioned that before, like, that Tagalog has such benefits also in the way it breaks down words for pronunciation, like pa'alam, right? Like
pa'alam,
right? Mm-hmm. Pa'alam, but it's like spelled together. Pa'alam.
Mm-hmm.
But it's pa'alam, like, you actually break them out. And there's other words like umaasa, right? Like, it's some words just naturally. There's also like a, like that, like the show, like Tawaknang, Tahalang, like that, that's fucking genius.
Yeah, because it uses so many plosives and the glottal sets.
That's what it is.
They're so clever when it comes to, again, it's one of the beauties of the language, like that's one of the advantages, but those glottals become so prevalent and they're so advantageous for the rhythmicality of phrasing, especially when it comes to diction. They become so prominent, and like, even if you don't want it to be so bouncy, the nature of the language just allows you to do so.
Yeah.
And yes, again, it's such a difference when you hear, for example, Spanish rap or Latin American rap,
Korean rap.
And they all have their advantages because of the language. But I do believe that from all the different types of raps in different languages that we have been exposed to, I think Tagalog really wins it over, because it has that. It provides that bounciness, the ability to provide such a plosive, explosive feel to the rhyme itself. And the storytelling becomes quite prominent. Even if you don't understand the language, you understand where the intent is leading you. So that's pretty cool.
I think also, like, again, this is sometimes why I'm a bit apprehensive of sort of checking out and doing a full podcast on, like, rap from parts of the world that we don't know, unless it's the first time. Because, you know, the magic of rap is... It's
truly the lyricism.
Yeah, it's, you know, how much you can gather, learn, and dissect from lyricism. That's essentially the power of rap. So I am always apprehensive to do this type of stuff, but you can still appreciate kind of the beauty of the language and the huge benefits that other styles of rap don't have because of the language. But yeah, nice from Flo G, dog.
Flo G is pretty dope. I like his stuff. I think he's pretty cool. I do, though.
Yeah. No, it sounded like a rehearsed.
No.
I like him. I think he's pretty cool. I think he's pretty cool, too. You know who else I think he's pretty cool?
Easy Meal.
That's right. Also, we're going to watch him perform live. That's pretty sick.
He's here in London. Shut up. Cool stuff.
He has just released a new song.
Will You?
And he has, like, his fucking songs have like a description. Look at this.
I don't know if this is like a ballad, like a more singy-songy thing that he has released. I'm actually not sure. But he filmed it with his girlfriend.
No way.
Yeah, his girlfriend is the female.
Just with that same love getting deeper, all of Easy's alter entities join forces to let him bear his soul to the Empress on his grandiose ballad.
Ah, see, it's a ballad.
With stadium-wide reverbed drums that set off the light of Easy's soaring vocals about devotion to his one and only.
None.
Accompanied by string, led with a choir-esque hook.
What?
Awesome blah. Wow, awesome. So maybe we shouldn't check this one out. I mean, maybe we should. Maybe we'll close it. Have we seen Dalawan put? We have, right?
Yes. We have seen it on the Wish Bus. He was pretty freaking dope. That was really good. But yeah, that's his latest release, I think.
Yeah, but it's a ballad.
It is a ballad.
That's quite mad for this podcast, isn't it?
Yeah,
fucking mental.
But yeah, if you haven't heard it, please go give it a listen. It's a pretty freaking sick song.
Have you heard his 24 bars challenge?
I don't think I have. No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I think I've seen bits and bobs.
Well, it's not very long,
but it yeah.
It's not very long. He translated as well.
You're so sick. Okay, damn. You see what I mean? So plosive.
Yeah. My neck and my dick.
Shit. 22 double O's. Yeah, that's Mark, the.
You suck at making beats.
Yeah, that's that's what yeah, that made him blow the hell up.
That dude is cool. I like that dude.
Yeah,
he's
that was one of the videos
I've never seen that.
Yeah, yeah, because he went so viral, and then he did it again, right? He did 44.
Did he?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, cool, dude.
He did 44. Yeah.
Because that was the 24 bar.
Yeah, no, he did. He never did 44. Mm. He did 27 bodies, but that was when he actually did. That was, I think, prior to that.
Nice. Yeah,
that was one of the things.
That's pretty cool.
Poof, blew up, it was so smart from him. Like, you know, this has like nearly 10 million views.
Yeah,
It was so smart for him because to you know, play to both languages and also mm-hmm, you know mm-hmm. cater to you know the styles that he's also sort of liked, and start to have sort of a what would you call it hints of his own personal style, because you can do you know this type of freestyles, you can do this type of bar challenges, but they may not necessarily then translate really well when you go into the booth and create a project.
That's right.
But they were always glimpses from his capability, his creative capability, and musical pedigree to not only be like a viral sensation, but then also go ahead and create, you know, good, consistent projects.
I totally agree. He's again, if you haven't seen that podcast, give it a listen. It's a pretty cool explanation of why there's so many different aspects to his influences in his rap, in his music, because he doesn't only just do rap, which I find that so cool about him, right? Because it allows you to understand that this new generation of musicians bring more than just what it meets the surface, and that's pretty dope. Like there is so much growth in that. I that's dope. I had never seen that, but that's dope.
I thought there's also another request that I have no idea about that you guys kept sort of sending through.
This is so popular. This has like 2 million views, and it was released in like late July, I think.
Right, it's called Mahal Kong Pilipinas.
Pilipinas, yeah.
The problem is I couldn't find the lyrics.
I think this song is very, very popular. I don't know if this is like a cover of another song or if this is the original artist. So again.
Mahal Kong.
We're about to find out.
Mahal Kong Pilipinas. How the hell do you spell that? Oh, Kong with G.
Kong.
Oh, English. Lyrics. Let's have a look. Pilipinas Kong Mahal. That's not right.
I don't think that's the same.
What the hell?
But I think it might translate into the same thing.
Mahal Kong Pilipinas. Jay Mara. Oh, that was ingenious. Nice.
This song blew up.
Really?
In that music video. Yeah, it was everywhere. Again, I don't know if this is the original or if it's a cover or influenced by something else. But then again, let us know. I'm sure you will. Have a look.
Oh, it's ingenious. Oh, shit. Okay, dog. I'm intrigued as fuck.
It's like a whole team, though.
Wish 107. That guy's been in fights.
Vocals. This is supposed to be rap?
This guy's unreal.
Araw, araw, Gabi.
I love this guy. Chanchinelas.
Mahal, mahal con Pilipinas, bro. This is sick.
Chilenas.
She's cool. Dude, what on the earth?
This guy is a joke.
This is ridiculous.
The guy in the background flipped off the camera.
Did he?
Yeah.
Nice. Nice.
I got a theory though. Protect the Filipino music industry at all costs, dog. Look at this motherfucker.
He's ridiculously... He's so good. When was the last time that you heard a rapper do that?
So smart to bring his team like that. Fill the void even more.
Yeah.
Sonic void.
Nice. Damn. Bro, that's absolutely outstanding. That's ridiculous.
Oh,
That is so good. Imagine that with a live band, bro.
Yeah.
Oh, ridiculous.
What the fuck, double bass? Oh my god, what the fuck?
Brilliant, freaking fantastic. Sir. That is so good. That is so good.
Damn, I hope they know they murdered that shit.
That was so good. That is nuts. Think about it. That's absolutely ridiculous. Again, I think that song already existed, and they kind of made like a home remake. Am I right? What does the description say?
The rousing and ponderous piece presents the hardships that Filipinos face.
Filipino rapper Jay Mara heard this song before?
Performs Mahal con Pilipinas.
I heard somebody else sing it. I'm 100% sure about that.
Because it translates to my beloved Philippines.
Yeah.
Do you love me? My slippers are about to have holes. And yet we're still poor, nothing to eat, nowhere to live. It's so hard to find a job. Why must it be like this? Why, whoa, my beloved Philippines, do you love me? My slippers are about to have holes. And then he goes to verse one. I look like a rag now due to work. My hands are full of wounds and thick calluses. The case is I still can't seem to feel any relief. My tongue chokes up medicine that has no effect. It's even rare to get anything out of people's puppets. Maybe perhaps it means fucking pockets. Yes, we're so many here every day thinking about how, but even every plan seems impossible. After I pay for a debt, a new debt comes along. That's how a lot of people feel right nowadays. It sort of non-stop. And why you ask? Because it's not enough. It's never enough. What I learned today, I already spent yesterday. I used it to buy food. What I earned today. My beloved, damn, that fucking phrase there, dude, that's so fucking relatable. Like, back home, that was kind of like, yeah.
Still is. It's a reality.
Well, and now it's fucking even worse. But we were growing up, it was starting to get that, you know, shit. And this is sort of, yeah, well, why is it not enough? But it's fucking never enough. And what I earned today, you sort of live truly bite by bite, day by day. That's brutal. And then verse two is, please forgive me for what I've done. Whatever life gives us, we have to be grateful for. Mm. No matter how much it gives you a hard time, no one has a right. It's only you and no one else who should be believed. Whatever thing that comes from you should be given care. Whether there is or isn't a blessing, you should always be thankful. Life comes from God, so no matter what happens to you, no one can stop. Oh, it's hard. But you aren't the only one experiencing this. Every creature in the world is going through something. So if you're poor and you also don't believe in God, you don't have the right to complain. Chorus, love the Philippines no matter what happens to you. Even if you get holes or get wrecked, you know you shouldn't ever stop. Love the Philippines, even if you trip, get holes or get wrecked, never stop. Love the Philippines. And then it sort of repeats itself. Love the Philippines and don't ever stop. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's something also like to that sentence there, like... you know, people are also going through this, you know, every mm-hmm. creature in the world is going through something. Yeah, there seems to be, you know, what would you call it? There seems to be, we seem to find some type of peace.
We find solace in the understanding that we're not alone in our suffering.
Yeah, in all the suffering, you know.
That's right.
It's also realistic to a certain extent. And the mad thing is...
There is such a comforting effect to understanding that you are not the only one going through a tough time, that you're not lonely in the process. I think there's also that the phrase of like "message in a bottle" by Sting. Mm. That says the same. Like, you know, I found 100,000 people that felt exactly the same way as I did, lonely and depressed. But at the same, we're all together in the same boat, kind of thing. And I think that
You can find that's odd comfort, in that.
Yeah, yep. There's an odd comfort in that. It's a bizarre experience, but that's the only given thing in life.
What's even more bizarre is, and we spoke about this the other day, you notice it in the sort of places. I think we spoke it to John.
John Guelas, yeah.
Yeah, he's also coming to Wanamex and stuff. And we just recently did a podcast, and we were just discussing, you know, he grew up in Cambridge, you know, completely different fucking world. It's not even London. That's probably more Britain than anything. You really get British culture there. And he grew up in Cambridge, you know, probably like a normal lad in Britain. And when he moved this year to the Philippines, you know, it really hit him because everyone's struggling kind of thing from sort of his perspective and his point of view. It's a very big shock, you know. To us, it probably won't be that big of a shock when we do visit because...
We come from a very similar...
Yeah.
Third world country.
It's actually... It's fucked, you know, and you kind of get used to that. You know, that's not normal, but it is what it is.
Everybody is in the slums.
yes and no. You know, there is wealth, but it's a very odd type of wealth where it's like...
But I'm talking about the common
majority.
The regular person. The common majority isn't having it nice.
So to him, it was sort of very shocking. And one of the things he was saying, everyone is sort of struggling to put, you know, bread in the table. However... Everyone's so happy every day. Everyone's smiling.
And it's such a mindset.
Yeah, and everyone's singing. Everyone's dancing. Everyone is taking day by day, being kind
Rolling
and pleasant
punches,
to each other.
Basically,
you kind of roll with the punches. And yeah, my mother was the one that sort of put this into perspective. We just went out for dinner the other day and we were just talking. And she was like, I think we were just for afternoon tea or whatever. And she was just saying that when you've nothing else, because she grew up, you know, in the 70s in Venezuela, in the shitta, you know what I mean? In the gutter, like hood as it gets. Her parents are as hood as it gets. They lost it because they work really hard and they kind of moved up in the world and they've done so well for themselves. They did so well for themselves in Venezuela. So it's like she explained it really well. It's like when you have nothing, you hold on to the little things that you have so tightly, and the things that you have are not physical, they're not materialistic. They are your emotions, they are your passion, they are your ambition, they are your dreams, your goals, your happiness, your ability to take care of the little things that you have, the plans, your friends, your books, maybe the pencil that you get given that day. You know?
It is also like you learn to appreciate the minute things in life that to some other people might seem absolutely...
Even to this day, our mother, so like when she gets a freshly baked bread, I'm exposing her here a little, but like bread, like that like French baguette type of bread that comes out of the bakery and it's like freshly made, it's like warm and nice.
And it smells divine.
She finds such happiness. I've never
such
seen anyone
joy.
joyful and truly happy for warm bread.
Yeah.
You know, and you know, we always ask, like, what the fuck, mom? And then she's like, you know, when you were a kid and
she didn't have, like, buying bread was such a luxury.
And,
like,
they would
save up all week
to buy that and
to be able to buy it by Friday.
And they would eat it with butter and that's it, dog.
And it was such an exhilarating experience. And I think as when you grow up in those environments, when you grow up with scarcity, and scarcity is your reality, you learn to find happiness, to find joy in the little task that you can give yourselves, the little moments that it'll provide you mere happiness. That those are so celebrated.
What's even more cool to see as well is like, because it is a rap podcast and sort of underground and urban.
The social commentary is so prevalent.
Well, it's only, you know, obviously, but that because that's what they see. They mm-hmm. What the fuck are they going to write about apart from the things that they see, experience and witness every day? But the fact that they can sort of find relatability, inspiration in those things and then create art, and then that art gives them the opportunity to put food in their table and hopefully... Mm-hmm. You know, we've seen these incredible, really successful rappers from the Philippines that are now doing great for themselves, making a lot of money, and they're touring in the US and they're touring all over the world. And maybe this gives them the opportunity as well to do what I think would help. You know, it's putting kind of the musical pedigree and the huge talent that the Philippines has at a global scale. Because I genuinely think at the moment, in terms of pedigree per se, raw talent, per raw talent in comparison, the Philippines is on a league of its own at the moment. And even in technical singers on its own, they may not be the best-selling artists in the world at the moment. You know, do they compete with the Ariana Grandes, with the Dua Lipas? No. But vocally speaking, they are better than all of these charting artists. And I think it's a matter of time. I think the internet is playing its role. And you are seeing it, you know. The Wish Bus is a good example of that. You see all these clips from, you know, national television shows that are doing well. You see the guys coming over to London, you know, where you guys will see the pictures, you know. I'm sure crowds will turn out and the experience is going to be great, you know. So things are happening, which I think are awesome. And it's so awesome to see these sort of urban artists as well change their own lives through their own means, believing and also holding up the love for their sort of nation up high, you know. Anyways, that's
what
pretty
a great
much it.
Podcast.
Yeah.
Yeah. What an. I think this is one of the things that, again, that's why I never say no to any, stylistically speaking, any genres or anything like that. Hey, that's
me. Shut up, kid.
Because it allows you to discover new things and dive in a little bit deeper into the culture, the appreciation of the language itself, the understanding lyricism, even translated. There's a lot of things that you can really allow yourself to diving deeper into a specific industry given any part of the world. So yeah, I always come into this podcast with a really open-minded.
Well, I hope you find something new. You know, we do know we have people from all over the world and stuff. So I hope you enjoyed it, and let's close out with Easy Mills Ballad.
Ooh, okay.
A film by Rap Esguerra.
It's beautiful imagery though.
What is that, like rice? Rice fields.
Yeah, rice fields. Oh, this is so sweet. And this guy raps like that too. Come on, give me a break.
What a song. It's really cool to see the equalization of the track, because it really plays as well to the visual sort of effect of the fields and the voices of the wind.
Yeah,
it's so great. Yeah, it's very grandeur. Yeah. That wasn't acting, dog. That's genuine.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Was that a bird?
No, it's a... I think it's a cow. It looks like a cow. I don't know.
It looks like a pigeon.
No, I'm
what
coming
the hell
with
was
all
that?
My... I'm coming with all my Janeiro knowledge. It looks like, I don't know. It feels like it could be a flower.
It's like a headless chicken or something.
It's not.
It
it's
is
not.
A farm. You know, that happens in farms. They do that in farms.
I do know. Yes. We did have farms, Ephra. This chorus, bro, this is going to make me cry.
How the fuck? Damn, this guy's so versatile, so impressive.
Isn't it? That's what I said. Oh my god, you remember kerosene lamps?
Yeah.
When the light used to go up?
Oh, his signature is kind of similar to mine. That's not kerosene. That's like just a candle, bro.
No, I think those are kerosene lamps, bro. I grew up with no
kerosene. I think it's in English called kerosene. Yeah, it looks like one. Yeah. You know what's crazy? It's like
it's the amount of smoke that's coming out of them that makes me think of it.
you know, it's really interesting
that
as well.
Is
like
so
the more
sweet.
The more he sort of commits to also, you know, because when you start versatile, you may be apprehensive personally of, you know, I think I may be better at this style.
Yeah,
I may
what,
be better
where
at that.
To commit. Yes.
It doesn't necessarily mean that you're shit at them. It's just your personal demons inside and your voice inside you may be telling you different things.
Yeah.
And this, to me, when you always see an artist do this, and he didn't have to release this, I guess he just wanted to. You know, it's also a very personal
such
piece.
Such a personal, yeah, such a personal... the confession of love.
Yeah, it's always
so
nice
big,
to
yeah.
see someone find love at that level. But I wish him all the best. But when you see an artist sort of commit to other sides of them that perhaps they haven't explored as much publicly, and then release it, you always think, well, he must be in a place personally, which those voices in your head, that sort of artist curse that's always talking to you, it's a probably under control, or he's feeling confident enough to put this out. And you want an artist, if you're a fan of any artist, to do different things. You don't want him to be boxed, because yes, perhaps you want him to always keep that sound, but at the same time you want them to also explore new things. Sorry, I don't know, it stopped recording, so I have no idea
when.
But no, I do know when, so you definitely got to see this. But yeah, you want your artist to sort of be as experimental and also learn from creating and having sort of the cojones of posting new stuff and being vulnerable in the public eye when it comes to art. So that's always fantastic, and I'm sure he's going to evolve. I'd love to hear his sort of opinion, so maybe we'll get a chance to talk to him during 1MX on, you know, why release this now, and the sort of perhaps he's had this in the logs, in the archives
the
for a little while,
but
maybe now time seems to be correct. But apart from that, guys, that's pretty much it. If you'd like to get your tickets, 1MX, do click the link in the description below. You can use this code to save some money, where you will get, you know, absolutely packed with content. I don't know if it's going to be... We will have a live stream today, but I'm not sure whether the event actually has a full official live stream. I actually don't think so. So got to get your tickets if you want to meet us and if you want to see those amazing performances in person. And apart from that, ladies and gentlemen, anything you want to add?
No, that's it. Goodbye.
Adios.
See ya.